Welcome back, y'all. Welcome back. No, it's not working. Welcome back to the YogaAnds channel. This is the third installment of the 6-part YogaAnds Beginner Series. Thank y'all so much for tuning in. So today is all about wrists, forearms, and fingers. We're going to be helping people get into arm balances if that's what they desire. Or if not, just staying limber in forearms. You know, that's important too. Make sure you don't got no carpal tunnel. So join me on the mat, grab whatever props that you need to get yourself comfortable, and let go. All right. So we're going to begin today's practice on hands and knees. Come into a tabletop position. Fingers are spread, toes tucked under. Inhale, take a gentle rock forward. Exhale, sit bones come back toward heels. Inhale, rock forward. Really press your fingertips into your mat. Exhale, come back down toward heels. Inhale, rock forward. Notice, or you want to bring attention to your core. Make sure that it's stabilized. Exhale, come back towards your heels. Take two more rocks at your own pace. This is really important for people who want to press up into things like handstand. You want to make sure that you have strong fingers, strong wrists, and forearms. Back to tabletop. Reverse your hands. Middle fingers point towards your knees. Inhale. Bend your elbows. Exhale, push back up. Inhale, elbows bend. Exhale, straighten your arms. The back of your wrists usually get ignored until you get into arm balance like crow or something like that, and you realize that they're not strong enough for you to balance. If anybody watches my Instagram stories, they notice that I do this quite a bit for wrist mobility. So work the back of your wrist, work the front of your wrist. Very, very, very important. Take two more. There we go, back to stillness. Reverse your hands, back facing forward. Make balls come into a cat-cow position, or coming into a cat-cow. Inhale, gaze comes toward the ceiling, tailbone lifts. Exhale, push yourself away from the mat. Really dig your fist into your mat as you push yourself away around your spine. Inhale, gaze toward the ceiling. Exhale. Push yourself away from your mat. Strong, strong, strong. Look in between your knees. Inhale. Exhale. Knock a couple of these out at your own pace. Just remember to really dig those fists into the mat. And when you're digging your fist into the mat, you should not only feel a stretch on the outer part of your wrist, but also in your forearm. Couple more of these at your own pace. And then back to stillness. Bring your sits bones onto your heels. So untuck your toes. Bring out your wrists. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Interlace your hands. Push your hands away from you, heart center. Take 5 deep breaths.
Two more. Release your hands down by side. Squeeze your arms, making fists for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The next pose we're going to do may seem a little scary once you hear the word plank, but just know, because this is a beginner series, we're going to be doing a modified plank pose. We're just going to use the regular plank pose just to help improve our form. So slowly start to walk forward, and walk your hands forward. Walk your feet back. Plank. Drop your knees where they were. And that's how you know that you hopefully have the correct plank form. Now, for people who have knee issues, feel free to grab a cushion, rugs, jackets, pillows, whatever you can grab because you're in your house. So it makes it pretty simple to be able to grab something to help you with this pose. Once you're comfortable in your plank position, your modified plank position, I want you to really draw your navel in because it's still a core pose. But pay attention as you breathe to the muscles in your arms, the muscles in your wrists, and the muscles in your fingers. What do you feel? Three more breaths. And slowly walk back into a seated position. Very good. Ring it out. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Back into a plank. Walk your hands forward. This time we're going to do a side plank, modified side plank pose. Your knee comes forward, your back foot drops back on the mat, and you can see my foot is facing forward. Arm shoots up, side plank. We're going to take this for 5 breaths, and right now, pay attention to not only your core, but how do you feel this arm that's planted on the ground? Do you feel the stretch in your wrists? 4, 3, bring your arm back down to the ground, bring your knees back facing forward, and then we're going to go to the opposite side, foot plant on the mat, again facing front, your toes are facing forward, your gaze is on the hand that's shooting up toward the ceiling. And again, this isn't so much to work your core. This is more so about your arm and your wrist. So pay attention to what's going on there. How does your hand feel? 2, 1. Bring your hand back down to the mat. Bring your knees back down to the mat. See, now that wasn't so scary, was it? Come back onto your heels. Pump your fists. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Interlace your fingers. Push your hands away from you, heart center, for 5 breaths. Inhale through the nose. Even deeper exhale out the mouth. Two more. Hands release down my side. Bring it out. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, position. Your feet are hip width distance apart. Hands are shoulder width distance apart. Ball your fist up, coming back into a cat cow. So inhale, as your gaze lifts toward the ceiling. Exhale, push yourself away from the mat, round your spine, gaze comes in between your knees. Take a couple of these at your own pace. Notice the difference in how you feel this time. Do you still feel the same muscles being stretched? Or are your muscles more relaxed now? They're more used to the movement. I can tell you now, I felt it the first time more in my wrist on the side, and now I don't feel anything there. Take two more. Tabletop position, back to stillness. Reverse your hands. Fingers point toward your middle knee. Middle finger point toward your knee. Bend your arms on your inhale. Exhale, push yourself back up to straight arms. Inhale, bend. Exhale, straighten. Inhale, bend. Exhale, straighten. Check in. How is the back of your wrist feeling this time? Are you feeling as though you can go even for a deeper stretch? If you can, bend a little deeper. Exhale, straighten. Take two more. Reverse. Inhale. Slowly rock forward. Staple core. Press into your fingers. Exhale. Push your sit bones back towards your heels. Inhale. Slowly rock forward. Let's check in. Are you able to go a little further? As you can see, this time I'm going a little further up. Exhale. I notice the further I go up, I also feel it in my shoulders, my triceps, and my biceps. A holistic experience this is. We're using all of our muscles. Two more, inhale. Top. Bring your toes in, or bring your legs in to meet. Untuck your toes. Palm on to your heels. Bring out your wrists. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale. Hands come up. Exhale. Heart center. Thank you for joining me today in my practice. Thank yourself. Hey there, YogaAnds fam. Thank you so much for watching this video. We're at the third installment of the 6-part beginner series, halfway through. Make sure that you haven't done so already, you subscribe to the channel. Make sure that you like, comment, and please share with your friends. It really does help with the growth of our channel and getting this yoga, this love out to everyone. Again, subscribe, like, comment, and share. And I will see you next week for the fourth installment, which is going to be all about the back. So let your friends know.